Okay, I need to make up some more of these pigtails. Do you want to go ahead and make one up for me?
Sure.
All right. What it is we have a piggyback connector that will go on this resistor. We've got some elevator drives that don't have that center tap to the bus. They just came out without it, and they really need it. So it's between two large wattage, 50 watt, 3.6 thousand ohm resistors. So basically what we got to do is put that piggyback on there so that two of them will connect. It doesn't matter which resistor we go to. So two wires connect. One jumps from here to here. One jumps from here to the DC bus. So we need to make one up. This one I made up already before you got down here. So let's make this one up. You can start by stripping the wire. This is 10 gauge wire. I've got the setting at a good depth to work on both these terminals. So go ahead and try that. Strip both ends. Okay, so what we want to do is just check the ends first. So these are two different brands, actually. So the strip length, you're really supposed to check the data sheet, but nobody's going to do that. We just stick it in there and take a look. So go ahead and slide that on there. And we just want to make sure the copper comes out a little bit, but not too far. Okay, so that's pretty good. That's about perfect right there. You want to see it exposed a little bit. You don't want it in the way, because that's going to have to go on a quarter inch bolt. So that side will work. Let's check this one now. That one you can see has a little stop in there. And we just want to make sure the copper gets in there, but the insulation still gets crimped for the second stage strain relief on the insulation. So put that one in there and let's take a look. Okay, so that looks pretty good. So we see the copper hits the stop, and then the insulation is on the second stage, or sometimes they call it a dual crimp. This crimper is a two-stage or a double crimp. One is on the copper, and then the other actually crimps this to the insulation for a little strain relief. What we want to do is just put this in here first, and then butt that up right there. You can click it a little bit. See, now it's holding it. So a lot of times you can do that. It just kind of holds it in place. Then we want to take this, make sure it's in there, and then just squeeze until it lets go. Double check, do a pull test. Okay, so that crimped that and the insulation. This is a little bit of a cheaper terminal, not one of my better quality ones. I just had it laying around. So it didn't really squeeze real tight on the second stage. That PVC is a little bit thin. This one will crimp better. So let's take a look at this one. We'll put this in here, same thing. So now we'll put that in, see it on the end. And this one's gonna take a lot more pressure to actually crimp. And you can see it actually crimped to the insulation for a little bit of strain relief. And then we have a real solid crimp right there, and it's real tight. So you definitely want to tug on each side. This will be real low current. It's just to balance the both sides of the capacitor bank. But you still do want a good connection. So then we will slip, let's see, what do we want to do? Slip this one on here, and then there's two of these in the elevator, and then that'll just slip on like that, and then your other one will go to the other resistor. So really that's what it is. So now we got them ready to go, and there's a lot of elevators I have to do that too, so I'll probably pre-make a bunch of them.
You just bumped me.
Well, my apologies. So that's, you know, that's that resistor, R1 or R2. They're both 3.6 thousand ohm. Center tap here, so real low current, but you still want to make sure you have a real good connector. Like I said, these are kind of cheap. I need to get some better quality. It didn't crimp quite as good. You can see if you look at it. Let's get this to focus. That's a good indentation right there. So that's the first stage, and that's the second stage. On this side, that PVC is just a lot thinner. It didn't really crimp as well. So I'll find out what brand that was, and I just won't buy anymore. I found them laying around. Somebody might have got it from an auto parts store. Never buy your crimps from an auto parts store. Get good quality crimps. Okay, so we can see right here that the grip on here is way stronger than the grip here, because that comes off pretty easy. But as somebody pointed out to me, I was really struggling this to get off, and I didn't make it look all smooth and stuff, and I'm still struggling, so I'll probably have to get a tool to pull that off. But once we put it on, we don't really want it back off, so that's a good thing. I wish this one pinched a little better, but again, that's because it's a cheap tool. We can pinch that down a tiny bit with channel locks. I've had to do that a lot. A lot of our intermittent problems are weak connections, both the crimp and the connection right here. So stick with quality stuff. Okay, so let me show you what that's going to look like. We're just going to pinch that down just a little bit. Get a little more pressure on it. Oh, that's much better. Yeah, that's a better connection. So this crimper is just a cheaper one. It's about $100 I think I paid for this whole set, which isn't bad. It's not a certified crimper. It's not a high-end. I'd like to get a much better crimp, but this is okay. I mean, if you're working on airplanes, you got to get the high-end stuff, but this is okay for a lot of what you're going to do, and it hits most of what you need. It even has the 90 degree flags and the uninsulated. Here are some quality terminals. These are Molex. I picked this up at Johnstone. It's about $50, which is a real good value. They didn't have the quarter inch stud size, or else I would have used these good ones, but they did have the good spades or quick disconnect, whichever one you want to call them. So I really probably should have used that instead of the cheap ones I had laying around. 3M makes real good quality stuff, and then TE Connectivity makes real high-end terminals. These are all samples they sent me to check out. This, for instance, is a PIDG. That's the top of the end. We'll do another video and then kind of compare the terminals and the difference in quality plus the different types. And then the piggyback, we call it, that I used was a Molex. They call it a three-way connector. They actually have other kinds like this. Three-way connector. I've never really used that. I think that's more HVAC. Johnstone's an HVAC company. Then they have these, which, you know, this gives you the flexibility of different wire sizes or whatnot. That, you know, you're stuck with the blue. So I do like this style a little bit better. But again, we'll check all that out in another video. And then we'll also look at different crimping tools and crimping techniques.